got a tablespoon of olive oil in here. We're going to cook some onion again. Kind of on an onion theme, aren't we? We've got some onion. We're going to use the portobello mushrooms this time rather than the regular sliced mushrooms. We've got a little garlic also, 2 teaspoons of garlic here. So we'll get these onions started. Then we'll put the, we'll put the garlic right in. We're just going to be careful that we watch this because we don't want this garlic to burn. Okay. And like I said, this makes a nice little side dish. I've already cooked the bow tie pasta. Otherwise, you'd sort of be doing that at the same time. I've got the fresh spinach, and actually one bag of spinach is actually the 4 cups, so the whole bag goes in there. And I'm going to go ahead and throw our mushrooms in. All right, with our portobello mushrooms, we're going to let that wilt a little bit. I'm going to put it in our I know you see the bottom of the pan browning a little bit, but when you add the liquid from the spinach, it just sort of takes it all up, which is what you want. That's some good flavor there. All right. Turn that down just a little bit more. Okay, now we've got our fresh thyme. And we just need a little bit of this. I believe it was 1 teaspoon, wasn't it? If you're going to use the dry, do you remember what the thing is? If you're going to use dry, you're going to use a little bit less. All right. Okay, there's our thyme. And our pasta. I'm going to add just a little bit of salt and pepper to this. It doesn't say that, but I felt that it needed it when I made it earlier. Just to taste. A little salt and a little pepper. We'll finish up our... All right, then this is done. This is a great side dish. And our Parmesan cheese when we get it in the bowl. Okay, so there we've got our bow tie pasta and mushrooms and spinach.